we start our press conference, and probably we'll do it in English. I mean, it depends on players, so it is more comfortable for them. And the game between Sergei Karagin and Peter Ulego just finished in a draw. And my question is to Sergei, was he surprised at the opening value choice of Peter?
Yeah, of course, I was very much surprised. I mean, I don't know if it was. If it was first time in your life,
maybe last one.
So I mean, it is a very big system with many complicated lines, and if my opponent was very good prepared, I'm sure he was very good prepared. So I decided to go to some side lines. I played bishop takes f6 and g3, which is, of course, not the most ambitious line, but I just wanted to get playable position and just to play chess. Yeah. But I think I didn't manage to play chess a lot because black easily equalized, and I mean. Later, I was very happy to get back this pawn on c4, and then I thought, okay, finally I equalized.
But you were ready to give this pawn at the beginning, I mean.
Yeah, the beginning, maybe I was still ambitious, but then I realized, why did I give it up?
So, later on?
I don't know, maybe Peter knows this line better.
Peter, actually, just Sergei said that you might know all the variations very well. That's why he was scared to go to the main lines. And so, what is your?
No, okay. Basically, it was kind of a psychological game. Yeah, it's there was a rest day before, so it was kind of an option that Sergei might go d4, because if there is no rest day, if you are e4 player, you hardly switch. But if it's a rest day, then you are, especially if you have some good seconds here. And usually I play the Queen's Indian, but Sergei is also playing the Queen's Indian. And I was already asking him a couple of questions in Queen's Indian, and I did not want to get now some questions myself. So I decided to go for the Ragozin, which I never played, and really, okay, clearly it's something that you only play if you studied correctly. I was really curious to see how Sergei will react. Basically, bishop g5 I expected, because this is the professional move. Because, yeah, really, after bishop b4, because cd, bishop g5, then you already go to some main line. After bishop g5, white still has his options to go either way. So bishop g5, h6, bishop f6, queen f6, g3. Well, this... Yeah, just one up. Mm-hmm. Yeah, g3 was really a surprise, because in this position I never seen this. But then actually it occurred to me that it's a transposition to some Catalan. So now in fact we are getting the same position like in Catalan, fourth move bishop b4 check, and if white plays knight c3 instead of bishop d2. And okay, so castles, bishop g2, d takes c4, castles. And knight c6, this is the key move. I think maybe Sergei underestimated this when he went for g3, because this is not a usual move to put the knight on c6.
Yeah, actually, I didn't expect it very much, yes.
Yeah, but then white is forced to play e3 and rook d8. Well, it's actually not my system in the Catalan, so I was also not completely familiar with all the subtleties, but okay, black is trying to push e5, so... Actually, queen a4 was very interesting, because I think this is probably a novelty. All I knew was queen e2, basically. But queen e2 is a move that already shows that white is trying to liquidate. Black plays e5. e5, queen takes c4, e takes d4, knight d5. I think there was some game. Maybe Almási Balog in Hungarian Championship once. And then queen d6, and it somehow lead to a quick draw. And queen a4 is a tricky move, because it gives options for black. Finally, I opted for a6. There was bishop d7.
I think a6 is good because
I think a6 was clever, yeah. But
because after bishop d7, probably white can play knight e5. Knight e5, queen takes b4. Knight f3 check, king h1. Now it's important that black cannot play e5 because of knight d5.
Yeah, just e5 and knight d5. Yeah, is the trap.
Yeah, and it's, also knight d2 instead of e5 doesn't give anything because of rook e1 simply.
And if I just go bishop c6?
Then rook ad1, I thought.
Rook ad1, yeah. Yeah, this is very funny position that instead of knight d2, if I play bishop c6, looks like. No. Instead of after 14,
so
king h1.
Mm-hmm.
King h1. No. In the there. Yeah. Now bishop c6 looks very natural because I put my bishop on the diagonal. I have a knight on f3. All looks fantastic, but actually these pieces are not going anywhere. Yeah.
Yeah. It's very complicated.
Rook ad1.
I don't know.
Rook ad1. And then this knight on f3 can also be trapped later on if white. Okay, it's very direct. I don't know, some knight g5 jump and where it leads.
Knight g5.
But okay, white also has d5 in any case. Yeah?
Oh, after knight g5, maybe I can take on c6 and to play f4.
Yeah, then the takes and f4. So it was. I saw this option, but it looked like it's not clear. And besides, after bishop d7, there was also queen c2, which was kind of interesting, I thought, because now I cannot push e5 because of knight d5, and now white tries to go some knight e4. But then I saw this a6, and a6 looked better.
Yeah, six is better, and now I don't have knight e5, probably because of the same line, knight e5, queen b4, knight f3, king h1, and here black has e5.
Yes, this is the difference. And then the knight will be really strong.
Yeah, so I played knight d2, but bishop d7 is very strong, actually. I blundered this because I thought I can play bishop takes c3. Bishop takes c6, bishop c3, knight e4.
But then actually queen e7 is the. I have so many options.
Yeah, you have a lot of options.
Yeah, because but not only queen e7, but I thought queen e7 is. Which move you were most afraid? Queen f3?
Queen f3, I thought.
Yeah, but queen f3.
Or queen f5, I think.
It's more or less the same. Yeah, then bishop takes d7.
Bishop takes b2.
Bishop takes b2. Yeah, there was this line.
Rook
b1, c3.
No, just to take queen e4, rook b2, b5.
Yes, this is also possible. Yeah,
And actually, I'm not sure what can make easily draw because takes c3 and might be a little bit dangerous for me. I wasn't sure.
But basically, actually, this was the point that when I saw this bishop d7 idea, then I realized that a6 knight d2 bishop d7 is maybe more tricky. It was very nice motif, this bishop d7.
Yeah. Okay. After queen c2, you could also play b5 or.
But then b3.
Yeah, b3. Yes.
No, because actually, at the start when I played a6, I underestimated queen c2. I thought that after queen c2, I will protect my pawn and things are very nice.
Yeah.
But but then here I realized it's not so easy. B5, b3.
Yeah, b3 takes on b3, knight b3, and.
Yeah, and this is now my queen is completely misplaced.
Yes, now I want to play knight e4, knight c5.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Okay, I have
this
compensation.
Is like this is like a Catalan with this a6 variation when white plays bishop g5, there are some lines, and then white always gets this compensation. So knight a5 looked a bit artificial, but
okay,
I'm holding on to the pawn. I open option to play bishop c6, also c5.
Yeah, and it's important that I don't have knight e4, queen e7, knight takes c4, knight c4. Knight c4 also the same. Queen e7 and black protects everything, and I cannot take on c4 because then black will have
bishop
b5.
Yeah, at the end.
Yes.
Yes, this is the point. So rook fd1 is professional.
Yeah, actually I expected here queen f5, bishop e4, queen h5. And I thought white had nothing better than bishop f3 and with a draw.
Yeah, well, actually I also had nothing against draw because I haven't seen how I can protect my pawn, and once if white takes back the pawn, then okay, then it's equal pawns and some space.
So maybe the game could be finished earlier.
Yes, well, the game could have finished anyway earlier probably, but okay, queen e7 was such a natural move, and okay, we basically it leads to this opposite colored bishop position, which is of course a dead draw.
Okay, maybe actually I should have played Queen c2 after bishop d5.
Queen c3
was a little bit better maybe.
Yeah, but in fact I could have after takes, okay, I just could not take the position seriously anymore. That was my problem. So instead of bishop d5, maybe I could take bishop e4 immediately.
Yeah, immediately, yes.
And
probably.
Then c5.
Ah, c5. Okay. No.
Because once I played bishop d5, I immediately realized that I had this option. I don't know if it's any good, but definitely it was.
Okay, at least I can play.
Okay, d5 or what?
No, I think I will take on c5.
Okay, this is bishop c5.
Queen b3.
Yeah, queen b3. Okay, rook takes d1 and rook b8. And then b6 a5.
No, maybe. Queen a4 somehow.
Yeah. Yeah, what bishop d6? Queen d4, yeah.
Okay, at least I don't have any risk and I can play a little bit.
Yeah, the bishop, your bishop is on the diagonal, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But yes, I thought maybe queen c3 was a little bit better because if black takes on e4 and plays c6, then I play b4. And but of course, I mean. Maybe here black can even play e5, d5, c5. Yeah.
After c6, before
yeah,
e5.
Maybe
no,
e5.
E5. E5, yes. E5 and d5, c5.
Yeah, probably. It's just good for you.
Yeah, my bishop is breathing.
Yeah.
Maybe white has this plan with bishop c2.
Yeah, but always g6, g6, h5. I will never let h4, h5 happen. Yeah.
Okay, then I think what? Ah, actually, what if I would have played like in the game bishop e4, queen e4, c6, b4, h4, yes, h4.
H5,
b4. Before f5, rook b1, g6, maybe.
No, if I take, what's happening? It
yeah,
looked a bit ugly.
Yeah, take.
I did
take,
not like d5.
Take d5, yes.
Yeah, bishop c5.
D. E6?
Yeah, rook d1, queen e6, and you change, yeah? Queen
yes,
e6 and
yes.
Rook d7.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And it was annoying, yeah, I couldn't. Yeah, so this line, I mean, it looks very natural, a takes b4, because now I can basically a b, bishop b4, d5, this is the point. Now the bishop is hanging, and now we see why Sergei included h4, h5 before,
yeah.
Because now he has good king, and now bishop c5. For example, then d takes e6, yeah, rook takes d1, queen takes e6, and now surprisingly white changes the queen takes e6, fe6, and rook d7, and black is pawn up, but maybe black is worse. So this was actually quite tricky. Yeah, all my pawns are weak, and they are not going anywhere, these pawns. And white will slowly collect, maybe all of them. Yeah, rook
yeah,
a1,
rook
a1,
okay.
Okay,
rook a1, bishop f1.
Okay, one, bishop one, rook b1, protect not from b8, but at least from b1.
Okay, but just king g2.
King g2, king f3, still.
Yeah, bishop c4, yeah, it's very unpleasant, yeah, because if one pawn falls, all of them will fall, yeah, all five. Yeah, I don't like this. Yeah, no, this was basically the trap, yeah, so always one has to watch out, but, okay, g6 is always useful.
Maybe here b5 was, or is it
it's the
just
same,
just the same, yes. Ah, you take on this.
No, because rook d3 was tricky. You kind of give me the option to win your pawn, yeah? But then I have to play f5, and this is very dangerous for a long time, yeah?
To play how?
I mean, I can take your pawn.
Yes.
A, B, but it looked like some kind of a provocation.
Yes.
Yeah. f5, now f5, because otherwise, again, d5. So queen f3, bishop takes b4.
Yeah, but here I thought to rook b3.
Rook b3, rook a4. And then I'm tied down, and now the queen is coming, and it might be unpleasant.
Yeah. So queen e2, and then queen c4.
Yeah.
Or
queen b2, or yeah. And finally, white will get back the pawn, and then I will regret all of this. Yeah. The pawn is not going back. At least.
But okay, rook d7 is just.
Yeah. Rook d7 is
precise.
Cement.
cement.
Yeah. Because now if rook d b3. because it's cement. What can I say? Then I can take a, b, a, b, rook a4.
Yeah, and b5, exactly.
c5.
Yes.
Yeah, and b5, c5. And now I'm absolutely fine. I'm winning. So, okay, basically b5. And then we took everything.
Okay, here I should have won the c file somehow. Maybe rook c2 was slightly better. No, yes. Rook c2.
Rook c2? What? Actually, why I cannot play e5? I did not understand during the
game. Of course,
game.
You can play.
I can't play e5. This is like some psychological ghost that I don't want to have the f7 weakness. But, I mean, okay, I'm opening up my pieces. What is it?
All the time you wanted to play e5 during
the game. Finally I played e5 and the bishop was on c6. Uh-huh. Which I was, I mean, okay, bishop on c6, I thought it's nice, but also out of the game. But okay, queen d6, bishop c6, and because this was psychological, because I offered Sergei to change everything, and then we can call it a day, but Sergei and bishop c6 showing some ambitions to make some more moves, so I thought, okay, this case I'm playing e5, because before I did not play e5 because I did not know if Sergei has any intentions. Yeah, we cannot offer draw. The position is dead equal. I kind of did my duty. I offered the exchange. He did not take it. Then okay, I'm forced to push e5.
Actually, I can just show white's plan to play king g2, rook c1 c2, then f4, e4. E5, king f3, king f4, and d5.
Exactly. But this is the problem. That now also maybe some f. I mean, he protects against bishop d2, and then if white gets f4, then I'm stuck with my rooks.
Yeah, of course. I mean, it's still difficult to do something.
But you will enjoy yourself.
Yes.
Yeah? you will enjoy yourself. No. I cannot allow this. No, because after bishop c6, it was clear that Sergei is still in this mood to push all his pawns. So I better stop them. Yeah, with d5.
I could have played bishop d5 here, but
but then king g7
gives nothing. Completely nothing.
Yes. Yeah, this is just a tricky move because there is some queen e8 check at the end.
Oh, you can even take.
But
on,
I can take.
Take on
queen
d4. Yes.
No, I calculated d takes e5, queen e5, bishop d5.
Yeah, also, but
but
that,
I just
take
king
g7. Yeah, king g7. Yes.
Yeah. Exactly.
And again, king
g7. Yeah, and it's.
It's just.
Basically not clear what white wants, because if white starts to push on the king side, then the bishop on c6 can be out of the game, actually. So
actually, you just mentioned that you would maybe agree for draw before, so what do you think about this rule in general, that you cannot offer a draw? It's difficult to, I don't know, somehow psychologically to play when position is equal.
Okay, actually, in our game, I think we didn't have big problems because of this, because we quickly found a repetition of moves, and even before, I could exchange all the rooks, and I mean, we would make a draw easily, I think. So, in our game, there were no problems.
But I mean, it somehow affects your decision, even how you make moves, this kind of rule.
Okay, sometimes it can make a difference, but basically, probably the rule is correct. Because the rule is, I think in order to stop players agreeing to draw when the position is very messy. Yeah, I mean, this is the most, probably the main idea, when nobody knows what's going on, it's quite a natural human reaction that you offer a draw. And okay, see what happens. If the opponent does not agree, then we continue. But
then you spend some time thinking, so you will.
Yes, but basically this does not exist, and okay, you have to focus on the game. Now a little bit the trick is this, yeah, when it looks like it's dead draw and you think that okay, you are trying to find the most logical way to finish the game, which sometimes is tricky, but in general it's okay.
Thank you. Есть ли вопросы? Пожалуйста.
Как в целом, на ваш взгляд, проходит турнир, и должны ли быть ваши пока еще результаты? И у Петра хотел бы спросить, как со здоровьем, потому что и восстановиться ли, что-то говорить, трудно было ли на это адаптироваться в предыдущем организме. Спасибо.
How do both players, you understood this? How both players feel about the tournament at the moment? And the second question was to Peter, how does he feel? Because before he told that there is this difference between his country and Tashkent, so how he feels now after a few days?
Well, I think the tournament is long enough, so there is plenty of time to acclimatize, but no, seriously. Basically, every day is better and better, and okay, yesterday was a rest day. I even did some bowling, which was quite nice, and okay, basically the tournament progresses, and it's still very, very long. Every day you have some very difficult opponent, but okay, this is our job, and I think all the players are now already completely focused for the tournament. All this tiredness at the beginning or problems with sleep already more or less passed.
Okay, I'm happy more or less with my result now at the tournament, and I think before this round I was sharing second place, and now I will share first place after today's day. Because I think Ponomarev won, or
I haven't
winning.
Seen actually.
It looked mean.
Yes.
So it's more or less fine at the moment.
Yeah.
And my question is actually, how do you plan your strategy for the tournament? Do you play each game like a different game, or it's just you have some ideas? You know, let's say this is the most important moment, or this is our opponent, or this is not.
Okay, actually, you can never know against whom you can lose or win. I mean. It depends very much how the game goes, and if this is normal game like today, I mean, of course, we cannot do anything. But if the game is very complicated, you can lose or win. You never know.
Well, of course, yeah, because here everybody is very strong, and really you are looking for your chances. And once you get your chance, it doesn't matter who do you play with. But if you don't get chances, then again, I mean, everybody is strong enough to play good. So you just focus on your own game, try to put as much pressure. If you get chance, especially, okay, basically this is from the white side, yeah, because with white you are trying to get chances. If you get, then it doesn't matter who is your opponent, but okay, this is, I think there are very few chances in such a tournament.
But actually this tournament proves that white don't get so many chances actually. Black also wins some games, so maybe this is always this problem that white cannot find how to fight for advantage, and black cannot find how to equalize in the end. It's just a mess. No, just I mean that, for example, today Rustam won with black pieces, and a few games before also black won. So probably, let's say white, sometimes maybe they overestimated this, the color of the pieces, don't you think? So? Or still it's logical.
Okay. Okay. At least when you play with white, you want to use your possibility to fight for advantage. But, you know, of course, if you don't equalize like today, then there is nothing to do.
Thank you. Do we have some questions? Есть ли вопросы? Пожалуйста.
вопросов нет, больше спасибо за участие.